Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Morning, Letitia, the birthday girl. You still celebrating? Are you still celebrating? Good morning. Good morning and welcome, 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 welcome. Good morning, Tanya. Good morning, sis. Good morning, Demetria. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning and welcome, welcome, welcome. So good to see you ladies this morning. So good to see you. Welcome to our conversation. Welcome to our conversation. This week we're talking about, good morning, Dawn Clark. Good morning. Welcome. This week we are talking about growing in our self-love. Good morning, Brenda. So good to see you. Growing in our self-love. What does that look like for us? That's what we're talking about this morning. Growing in our self-love. This gift that only we can give ourselves, right? No one else can give us the gift of self-love. I celebrate the entire month. Yay, Letitia. That's the way to do it, girl. That's the way to do it. Celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. Growing in our self-love, growing in that, and one of the things in life that we only can give ourselves. Nobody else can give it to us. That's why it's called self. Good morning, Andrea. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hello, 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 everyone. So that's what we're talking about. So what does that look like for you, beloved? What is your next step to grow in your self-love, right? So one way of growing is celebrating. So we got Letitia who is celebrating. January is the official celebration month for Letitia. And we join in her celebration. And one way of growing is to celebrate. When we get to the point, beloved, that we have no qualms, no hesitations, no funny feelings about celebrating ourselves, we have gotten to a significant level of self-love. Now, I always want to give the balance because celebrating ourselves, not in a narcissistic way, not in a us versus me versus them way, but in a way, understanding the significance of every person, that each one of us is significant. Each one of us has something to add to God's universe. Each one of us is each of us are to be celebrated. We are to be celebrated, right? Each person is to be celebrated, right? Wherever we are, whatever our contribution is, whatever, be just simply because we are, celebration is appropriate. And a lot of us don't know that, and we haven't been given permission to do that. We haven't seen it modeled. We actually have been told to do that is wrong, that it's narcissistic, it's bragging, it's putting yourself before others. And in some ways, we are to put ourselves before others, right? When it comes to the care of us, we're to care for us first so that we can care for others. We're to love us first so that we can love for others. We're to feed in some, like particularly, you know, everybody knows the airplane situation. If the airplane is going down, put the mask on you first so that you can turn around and care for other people. Don't keep the mask on you. Don't refuse to give up your mask at all costs. Don't ignore other people who need masks. Don't just stay there with your mask on and do nothing else. That's not self-love. Self-love reaches inward in order to reach outward. It reaches inward in order to reach outward, right? Outward and upward, it does. Self-love does not, it's not self-contained. It does not only remain with you. Self-love automatically has an external component built into it. When we're love, folk who are not loving themselves well have a difficult time loving other people. So if you find people who find it difficult to get along with other people, if you find people who don't like people, if you find people who continue to repeat the same toxic behavior with people, oftentimes they'll think it's the other people. But beloved, if we have a pattern that continues to repeat in our lives, it has way more to do with us than anybody else. That's the first thing I look at. The first thing. If I have a pattern, I'm like, oh, Kathy, okay, that's you. Something about that is you. You inviting it, you owning it, it's the environment, it's something. But you are a common denominator, sweetheart. That's how I talk to me. You a common denominator. So what we going to do? What we going to do to change that there pattern? You know what I mean? What we going to do? Good morning, Brenda. Good morning, sis. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. All right. All right. So self-love is a gift that only we can give to ourselves. It's a gift that no one else can give us, right? It only comes from us. We can only get it from ourselves. So we're growing in our self-love this week. We are growing in our self-love. We're looking at our moves, our activities, our engagements, our steps, right? To grow in our self-love. So what do you need to do, beloved? What do you need to do in order to grow there? So let's talk about our thinking. Let's think about our thinking. Is your thinking world the kind of world that increases the likelihood that you're going to grow in your self-love? Is your thinking world the kind of world, right, that increases the likelihood that you're going to grow in your self-love? Good morning, Patricia. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I can't even get it out. The way that you think every day. The way that you think every day. Where your mind has a tendency to park. What you have a tendency to notice. And then what you have a tendency to speak on. You see? What you have a tendency to give your attention to. Notice. Speak on. Give your attention to. That all has to deal with our thinking world. Is that world, right? Is that world a friendly world? Is it a friendly world for you? And I'm taking notes. And so is it a friendly world? And is it a world where it can increase your self-love capacity? Is it a world that can increase your self-love capacity? Do you see? So when something happens, you know, say you forget to do something. Say you forget to do something on your calendar. What do you say to yourself? Do you make excuses? Do you say it's someone else's fault? Do you begin with oughts, shoulds, or musts? Or do you simply say, okay, wow, Kathy, you missed that appointment. What you gonna do? What you gonna do to not do that again? Because it's not a good thing to miss appointments, because we waste people's time. We potentially waste other folks' time. And if anybody know anything about me, I value time. I value time. And I don't like mine to be wasted. And so it's why I keep my commitments. And so I'm a real stickler about time. If we say we're going to start at 12, let's start at 12. If we say we're going to end at 12:30, let's not end at 12:45. Do you see? Unless we've got permission, unless there's some extenuating circumstances to both the beginning and the end. And so that's one of the things that I value, right? So when I have a faux pas, I think that's the way you say it, in this thing called time, am I friendly to me when I have misstepped one of my values, when I've misstepped one of the things that I promote? Am I friendly to me in my thinking? Am I friendly to me? My thinking is going to go to my saying. Am I friendly to me, my thinking, and my saying then? And I've learned to be friendly. I haven't always been friendly. I used to say, Kathy, You should have done this. Like, why, girl, why would you do something? I used to. But because I've grown in my self-love, primarily my thinking is a friendly, environment. My thinking environment is a friendly environment. So one of the ways to grow in your self-love, beloved, is to make sure is to increase the friendliness of your thinking environment. So if we live in the world of you ought to do this, you should do this, you must do this in a way that imprisons you, right? That doesn't give you life. Now, sometimes there are oughts, shoulds, and musts, but not in an imprisoning. I ought to be the best version of me. I must see who I can become. I should take this next step. Those are friendly versions of oughts, shoulds, and musts, right? Friendly versions. But they are unfriendly versions that say, you ought to be better than that. You should not make mistakes. Any versions of those oughts, shoulds, and musts that are limiting versions, those are automatic signposts to stop. Stop your thinking and stop it from coming up from other folk as well. I'm just saying. To stop. Any of those are signposts for us to stop. And so good morning, Keisha Yerby. Good morning. Learn to be friendly to yourself in your thinking. Learn to be friendly in your thinking, because we're talking about thinking today. Tomorrow we're going to talk about our feelings, our emotions area, our feelings area. So be friendly to yourself in your thinking. So what is it? So you get a thought that's not a friendly thought, and then what do you do with it? Right? You get a thought. It's not a friendly thought. What do you do with it? Right? What do you do with it? Do you see? What's your next step? So let me just say this, beloved. That thought is not neutral. No thought is neutral. Thoughts are for better or worse. They're not neutral. Thoughts that propel us forward are better. Thoughts that stagnate us or move us backward are for worse. Thoughts are never neutral. They are for better or worse. Not neutral, right? They're not neutral. They are for better or worse. And so, any version of all should and must that is limiting is a sign, that's right, post for us to stop. Any of them that are limiting or imprisoning, right? Imprisoning is limited, right? Any of them that bind us, any of them, they're signposts, right? Now, again, there are some friendly oughts and some friendly shoulds and some friendly musts. You must become great. You must show up fully. You must be all that you can be. We must, right, be friendly, kind to one another. Right? We ought to walk out this life in courage. We ought to love one another. Do you see? So there are some friendly options in us. Friendly. But those that are limiting are those are the ones. So we want to make sure that our thinking is friendly. That's one way of growing in our self-love. So what do you need to do, beloved? What do you need to do today in your thinking in order to increase your self-love? So, you know, I've been put on this earth to help people grow in their self-love, help people to grow, to improve their thinking, to be able to effectively manage their emotions so that they can have amazing relationships, relationships with themselves, relationships with other people, relationship with God, however they refer to God, right? I've been put on this earth for those purposes. And so this today, we're asking you, is your thinking friendly? So that you can grow in your self-love. So that you can grow. So that you can grow. right? So that you can grow, right? Thoughts are never neutral. Thank you, scribe. Thank you, thank you. They are for better or worse. Thoughts that propel you forward are for better. Thoughts that stagnate you they're for worse. What do you need to do today that will improve your thoughts? What's your next step? I'm going to give you one clue. One clue is that to identify your thoughts. That's your step, right? Identify your thoughts, right? Identify them. And then once you identify them, right, you identify them and you decide if they're friendly. Friendly, not friendly, right? And then you're going to either fortify or you're going to work towards eradicating. That's it. It's a simple step, simple three-step process. Identify what the thought is, assess whether it's friendly or not, and then you're going to act. So you're going to identify, assess, and act. Okay? All righty, beloved. So, look, LTE call this Friday, this Saturday, 10:30 to noon. If you are not signed up to LTE, you are missing out on amazing opportunities. And so make sure you go, sign up, go to drkatharinejames.com, go to services and products, and sign up for LTE. It's $47. It's a subscription. So make sure because some people have signed up, but it wasn't the subscription. Make sure you sign up to the subscription, and it's a monthly subscription. So you determine how long you're going to stay, but I guarantee you it is well worth more than $47 a month, right? Well worth more than that. And so it's important for you to understand what it is that you are getting, beloved. Look, don't leave your next level of self-love on the table. For real, don't leave it on the table. Don't walk away from a gift. That LTE is a gift to you. LTE is a gift. Just to put it in frame. Anyway, just to put it in frame, it's something that you need to do. Make sure that you are walking out this thing called self-love. And if you need help, then you know how to reach me. Go to my website, reach out, send out a comment, and we'll see how we might walk together in this thing called self-love as we grow in it. I'm doing my work every day to grow in my self-love. Every day I'm working to grow in mine. I invite you to be active, to take your next steps, to do something intentional. Don't expect that it's just going to happen, right? We already know what habits are like. They don't just happen. We have to make an intention and invite somebody to hold us accountable. You want to grow in your self-love? You want to become the next best version of yourself? The next best version of the highest vision of yourself? I might just be able to help you with that. All right. Thanks, Brian. Have a good day. Stay safe and be mindful of your surroundings. Will do. At the moment that Abba gave us his breath, me and you, we forfeited the right to not be amazing. We gave it up. Thanks, Joy. Thanks. We gave up the right to not be amazing. All right. And so, you guys, just so that you know it, sometimes there's a delay here. And so I will have a conversation and then I'll have a conversation, but there's a delay. So by the time you post, if it's at the end, I've already signed off. So when I do that, I usually will come back and respond to your post in text, right? I'll respond to your post in text. So just so that you know that. So make sure that you have a plan for growing. Tomorrow we're going to talk about emotion and feelings, your self-love. What do you need to do? What is your emotional environment, your feeling environment? Is it friendly? Is it friendly? Where do you have a tendency to park? Have an amazing day. I love you. Sending love, grace, and peace. Make sure you give yourself permission. Not only permission, but you set a plan for growing in your self-love. All right, have an amazing day.